left on.
A Pharisee! Wow. And the other, a
twice a week. You get that? Twice a week. And pay taxes on all that I get.
But the other kept his distance and would not even raise his eyes up to the good Lord in heaven. I said the good Lord in heaven, child!
Yes, sister!
But beat upon his breast, saying,
"Oh, God! Have mercy on me, sinner that I am!"
And it was this man I told you.
Oh, you've got to be kidding.
And not the other who went off and quitted other sins. For every man who exalts himself, I'm too sexy for this parable, shall be humbled. And every man who humbles himself shall be exalted.
Exalted!
You have heard that they were told, "Do not commit murder. Anyone who commits murder must be brought to judgment." But what I tell you is this: anyone who nurses anger against his brother must be brought to judgment. So anyone who abuses his brother must answer for it in the court. But he who sneers at his brother must answer for it in the fires of the hell. Say you're bringing a gift to the altar. And you suddenly remember your brother has a grievance against you. No, leave your gift before the altar where it is. Leave it. First, go make peace with your brother. But be careful not to make a show of your religion before men.
Oh.
For if you do, no reward awaits you in the kingdom of my Father.
Oh.
No. When you do some act of charity, don't announce it with a flourish of trumpet, as the heathen do in the temples and in the streets. I tell you, they do it just to win admiration from men. No. When you do an act of charity, don't let your right hand know what your left hand is doing. Your good deed must be in secret.
Who told the third secret that was the first one that he told to the other guy, to God that was at the other guy?
What the rich man is buried in Hades, where he's to live in torment.
Yeah! Satan!
He looked up to heaven, and there far away was Abraham with Lazarus sitting close beside him.
Oh, Father Abraham, have pity on me! And hold the band to Lazarus. And now it is he who has consolation here, and it is you who are in agony. But there ain't all. There's a great chasm fixed between us, and nobody from your side who wants to cross it can, and nobody from our side who wants to cross it can, either.
Then, Father, send Lazarus to my father's house, where I have five brothers, to warn them so that they too may not come to this place of torment.
The fucking angel is coming!
They've got Moses and the prophets. Let them listen to them.
But if someone from the dead should rise, then they would listen.
Look, if they don't listen to Moses and the prophets, they ain't gonna listen to nobody. Even if they should, rise from the dead.
Yeah.
Nike.
Oh. Yeah.
Yes, rejoice and be exceedingly glad, for great is your reward in heaven.
When you feel sad or under a curse, your life is bad, your prospects are worse, your wife is sighs, cries, and your olive tree is dying. Tales are graying and teeth are decaying and quills weighing your hurting. Your food and your robe are all money blue.
Breezes and the sunshine and soft and fresh air.
on the run.
Who has the runs? Pass it on.
Probably Don. Pass it on.
What's the problem with Don?
Pass it on.
Cuban Missile Crisis. Pass it on.
Pass it on.
Prostitution. Pass it on. It was probably a nun.
That's an assignment.
Ship the property. So the father divided his estate between them. And the next day, the son turned the whole of the property into cash and left home for a distant country where he squandered it in reckless living. But then, a severe famine fell upon the land, and he began to feel the pinch. So, he decided to attach himself to one of the local landowners, where he mined pigs.
Pigs!
Pigs?
He would have been glad to have filled his belly with the path that the pigs were eating, but they wouldn't give him any. But then he came to his senses and said,
how many of my father's paid servants have more than they can eat? And here I am starving to death. I will go to my father, and I will say to him, Father, I've sinned against God and against you. I am no longer fit to be called your son. Treat me as one of your paid servants.
So the son set off for his father's house. And when he was a long, 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 long way off, his father saw him, and his heart went out to him. The son ran to meet his father, threw his arms around him, and kissed him. Saying,
Father, I have sinned against God and against you. I am no longer fit to be called your son. Treat me as one of your servants.
But the father would not listen to him, and he called to one of the servants, saying,
Quick, fetch my robe, my best one. The ring on his finger and shoes on his feet, and bring the fatted calf, and kill it. A nice kosher man. I will have a feast to celebrate the day, for this son of mine is lost and is found. And the festivities began.
Celebrate your times, come on, da-da-da-da, da-da-da-da.
And on his way back, as he approached the house, he heard music and dancing. He called out to one of the servants and asked him what it meant. The servant replied,
you're a brother-in-law.
Cousin! Your brother! Your brother's come back home again, and your father's killed the fatted calf because he had the back. But the brother was irritated.
Oh, come on!
He was pretty damn mad! And your kid was going to the house! The father came out and pleaded with him, but he retorted saying, No, I've worked for you all these years, and never once disobeyed your orders, and you never gave me so much as a kid for infesting my friends. But, once the son goes to the after running for your money with his women, you killed a fatted calf for him!
My boy, said the father, you will always beat me and everything I have is yours. Now, how could we help but celebrate this happy day? For your brother here is dead and has come back to life. Metaphorically speaking, was lost and is found.
Come on, guys.
No! Why should I?
Come on.
No! Oh, don't make me. All right.
A snake when he asks for fish?
No!
Well, if you now, bad as you are, now know how to give your children what is good for them, how much more will your Heavenly Father give good things?
Good things, good things, good things, good things, good things, yeah!
Those who ask them always treat others as you would have them treat you.
Yeah, yeah, yeah!
Well, that is the law and the promise.
The law and the promise, the law and the promise, and the law and the promise, 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 the law and the promise.
You are the love of the world! A bushel, whoo, it's lost something kind of crucial.
Got to stay right.
on a hill, it's kind of hard to hide it well.
Let's go! issues. Today our guest is the master. Now, master, sir, by whose authority are you acting like this?
Who gave you this authority?
Well, I have a question to ask you, and then I'll tell you by whose authority I act. The baptism of John, was it from God or from man?
Well, if he's saying from God, and you say, then why did you not believe?
But if we say from men, the people
will be angry, for they took John as a prophet.
We do not know.
Then neither will I tell you by whose authority I act. But I have a story for you. A man had two sons, and he called to the first and he said, "My son, go and work in the vineyard today." "I will go," said the son, but he did not go. Later he called to the second son and he said, "My son, go and work in the vineyard today." "I will not go," said the son, but later he changed his mind and went. Now, I ask you, which of these two did as his father wished?
I have said.
And I tell you, tax gatherers and prostitutes are entering the kingdom of heaven. For when John came and showed you the right way to live, you did not believe him. The tax gatherers and prostitutes did. And even when you saw this, you would not change your minds and follow him.
Master, if you're a wise man, answer me this. Are we or are we not permitted to pay taxes to the Roman Emperor?
Show me the coin to which the taxes paid. Now whose head's on it? Whose inscription?
Caesar's.
Well then, pay Caesar what is due Caesar. But pay God what is due God.
Yes, we have a question right here in the studio audience. I must say, this is a really great audience. Before we get to the question, I would like to remind you not to refrain from any verbal or physical abuse of the host or guest. Yes, sir, please stand up. What is your name, sir?
Ray Eichel.
And your occupation?
A teacher.
Yes, sir. May I call you Ray? What is your question?
Master, what is the greatest commandment of them all?
Good question.
Thanks.
Thou shalt love the Lord thy God with all thy heart and all thy soul. This is the greatest commandment of them all. And the second is like it. Thou shalt love thy neighbor as thyself. All the law and all the prophets are written based on these first two. The Pharisees and doctors of the law sit on the throne of Moses. Therefore, listen to what they say. Pay attention to their words, but do not heed their practices. For they say one thing and do another. Everything they do is done for show. Oh, they like to have their places of honor at feasts and in the synagogues, to be greeted respectfully in the streets, and to be called teacher. But you must not be called teacher. We have only one teacher, the Messiah. And you must not call any man master. We have only one master, and he is in heaven. Drunken friends. I tell you, his master will come on a day he does not know, at an hour he least expects, and will cut him to pieces. Then he'll take his place among the hypocrites, where there's wailing.
Wailing!
And gnashing of teeth.
Gnash, gnash, gnash!
Remember, even a good one, if he remains indifferent to the ways, can never enter the kingdom of my father.
Master, this woman was caught in the very act of adultery. And in the law that Moses has laid down, such women are to be stoned!
That the one of you who's without fault shall throw the first stone. Where are they now? Has no one condemned you?
No one, sir.
Then nor do I condemn you. You may go, not sin again.
Back there.
And then they will say to him,
Master, what was it was I hungry and gave him food?
He's been ready for you with the devil and his angels. When I was hungry, you did not give me food. When I was thirsty, you did not give me drink. When I was naked and without a home, you did not take me to your house. When I was ill and in prison, you did not come to my aid. Then they will say to him,
Oh, Master, if we'd have known it was you, we would have taken you to the corner 7-Eleven and bought you a Slurpee.
And then he will say to them, Anything you did not do for one of my brothers here, however humble, you did not do for me. Go take your places. But the righteous.
Humbly at thy feet we fall, prodigal confessing all. We beseech thee, hear us. We thy fall have disobeyed, into paths of sin have strayed, and repentance have delayed. We beseech thee, hear us. Sing my love, that man's virtue be.
Blood of the covenant which is shed for the forgiveness of sins. I tell you, I shall.
will never again drink from the fruit of the vine till I drink it again with you in the kingdom of my Father.
God, I'm bleeding. Hey, Ben? Could you come here, please?
Hello? Testing. Ready?
Okay, yeah.
Also testing. Hello? Alright, let's watch it.
Okay, let me go back.
Do the ceiling.
Thank you.
do this thing.
I don't want to get
to it.
That's a great idea. Because you're always missing the last 2 minutes. Hey, Katie. Hey, Katie. Take picture.
Don't be no more pictures.
Oh, you should already.